It's been another record-breaking cruise season for Sydney, with 265 luxury ships docking in the harbour. And to make way for even more next year, a second world-class terminal opened today at White Bay. Melinda Nusifora was there today as P&O's Pacific Pearl arrived this morning. She joins us live now. Mel, were there any teething problems today?
Dare I say it, Sandra, that it was smooth sailing down at the White Bay Terminal this morning. All throughout the day, 4,000 passengers have been processed without a hitch. A new dawn in Sydney and a new home for its cruising tourists. Just west of the CBD, the city's second cruise terminal welcomed its first visitors.
Morning, folks. Welcome. How are you guys travelling from here today?
The cruising industry is booming. It's up a third on last season and record bookings are already locked in for next year.
Over the last 5 or 6 years we've seen unprecedented growth. And to accommodate that, we have to build new facilities.
A $57 million White Bay site has been in the works for 3 years and is a far cry from the makeshift marquee which greeted tourists at Barangaroo.
A real seamless experience. Great from the boat to come off. It was the easiest experience we've ever had.
We were on and off. It probably took about 10 minutes. It was fabulous.
Operators expect a ship to dock at White Bay every second day. Neighbouring residents have rallied against the terminal for years, worried about noise and traffic congestion. Even at today's opening, locals voiced their public transport concerns.
But the level of consultation that's gone in here has been quite significant. I think we've had 13 meetings directly with the community where our own staff have sat and listened.
The state government will now turn its attentions to a multi-million dollar upgrade to the overseas passenger terminal at Circular Quay. Sandra, operators using the new White Bay terminal have agreed to what they're calling good neighbour guidelines. That means no late night arrivals and departures, and they'll keep noise and lights to a minimum so as not to disturb the local community.
Thank you, Mel.